Bren Rose's Food Cooperative is a member worker food cooperative, meaning that everyone who's a member has the same stake in the co-op. So everyone's put in the same amount of money. There's a membership fee that everyone's supposed to put in, and then everyone has to do the same amount of hours every single month. So we decided to do it where we have a member price and non-member price. When the food cooperative movement kind of started in the 70s, they did kind of a member price sort of thing, or they had like, you know, some sort of member working structure. There's a pretty broad range of what actually defines a co-op. So it's pretty much just where people come together for some sort of common cause. So if it's, you know, for in our case, we wanted a place for people to get nutritious food and kind of in an environment that's based around a member worker kind of structure.
We were definitely a very principled organization. We started, one of the first things we did was to draft a mission statement, and that included some of our basic principles. Mutual aid would be the most central idea to the cooperative. A mutual aid organization is one in which members of that organization work collectively towards a common goal, and each receive benefits equal to their participation.
One of the strongest, the biggest premise of Bren Rose is that we believe in the notion of mutual aid, meaning that, you know, we're all here to work together, and we're here to you know, like, by people putting in their effort, other people, you know, everyone else benefits from it.
The founding members were all interested in social justice movements and how they were organized in terms of collective projects which have a real benefit, a real primary benefit to the people who participate, which in this case, the grocery store, is everyone needs food. So if we can be getting our food supply through a cooperative enterprise, then it might kind of set the tone for other facets of our lives that we may be able to incorporate a cooperative ethic or mutualistic ethic.
So the consensus process is a process we use to basically govern the cooperative. It's a way for people to make decisions in a sort of a manner that kind of maximizes democratic participation. Proposals can be, you know, brought up within discussion, and people can use their body to communicate as clearly and immediately as possible how a proposal is sounding to them at the moment, or whether they have concerns, and that actually makes the process a lot more fluid and a lot more fast, in fact, when you can get that kind of immediate feedback. So there's lots of different hand signals used in the consensus process. If somebody is saying something that you like, something that you find accord with, you wiggle your fingers up. Basically, you're sort of endorsing an idea with your hands. If you're not into it, then you turn them upside down.
Consensus, which is the decision-making process here at Bren Rose's, works in a way that allows everyone's voices to be heard. So we will discuss a certain topic for however long we feel it needs to be discussed. And there's a thing called stack. And what we do with stack is write down everyone's name that has something to say. That way everyone gets a chance to say it, nobody interrupts. And then after that, we have a vote, and that is for smaller decision-making processes, things we're talking about around the store.
Our main goal is for people to have access to the food. We don't want to be seen as an expensive health food store like other places, you know, or even a lot of food co-ops. They're just seen as like a boutique kind of store. And we want to be a place that everyone can have access to, everyone can afford to shop here. You know, it's a hard thing to do when we try to just have healthy food, because healthy food is expensive. But, you know, we try our best to make it a place that people can access the food.
I think that access to organic and healthy foods is a fundamental right. I think that people are broadly understanding that now, more and more people are demanding that right to, you know, it's a desire, but it's also a right, you know, to eat healthy and organic food. We decided that if we were to cut out a lot of the unnecessary labor costs that go into a grocery store, if we actually just did the work ourselves with a few hours a month, we could get cheaper quality groceries, which we think is a fundamental right for working class people.
I think one of our goals is to get more people who haven't had access to nutritious foods to be able to come to a place like Bread and Roses for that, because, you know, especially in this neighborhood, it being more or less a food desert, that, you know, you're going to have people that their only options becomes convenience stores. And convenience stores are renowned for not having pretty much any healthy food. You know, having the option that we provide is, you know, a benefit for the area.
Localism was one of the ideas that got a lot of people interested in Bread and Roses, and still a big part of our operation today. We think that it's important to source as much food locally. There are a lot of reasons for that. I mean, you cut down on transportation costs, and also the environmental impacts of transportation and this sort of thing. The less shipping you have to do, the more environmentally friendly your products are going to be.
At Owen River Farm, we grow all types of vegetables. We really just try to grow everything, because so much about what we're doing here is trying to learn what varieties we like and what kind of vegetables we like to grow and how they do well. I think what I enjoy the most about being a farmer is the food. I'm really a foodie at heart. My mom was a really good cook, and I learned to cook when I grew up. I realized pretty quickly on that produce from the grocery store just isn't the same as fresh, homegrown produce. For me, I find that just taking care of my own business and really providing such quality produce here on the local scale, and supporting myself with the local economy, growing the local economy, is the best thing I can do. So I think it's everything to be supporting the local economy and be a part of the local economy. It's a lot of fun. On top of that, it's you know, I'm providing solar power in a way. Like, I'm making money out of the sunlight, and that's really exciting. I wish more people would get involved in the local economy and participate in local events and local community and local culture, because one of the best things you can do for sustainability is to shop locally. If you buy local produce, you're reducing the carbon footprint immensely. The best part about it is how personal it can be. I mean, you get to meet the person who made the product or grew the product, and you're supporting them directly. And it's more like family that way. It's just a closer experience. We come out here pretty early on Wednesday morning, and pretty much the first thing we need to do is harvest the tender greens. I call Christine up once I've weighed out what we have, see what we can kind of sell in small bulk, and pass that information on to Christine, and she lets me know what she wants. Working with a locally owned food co-op has been really nice. This farm is so small that I like to try to sell things at retail price as much as possible. Inevitably, we have some surplus, and it's so nice to be able to provide that to a place that's still really personal, because really the whole thing here is that kind of personal relationships. And so providing to a place like Bread and Roses has been just really nice. Feels like a community. Really happy to have people be able to just come in and see what, you know, is available from my farm on display there and pick it up. So just really, it's a great venue for us. Sometimes I do a little shopping there before I leave. It's been a lot of fun. Everyone seems real appreciative.
A big benefit, in my opinion, for the co-op is that it creates community. And you know, when I come here, I feel like it's a place that I'm part of, as opposed to just some store that I'm shopping in. And when I come to a place like that, it's much more inviting to me. The other thing that's important to me is that I really believe that democracy can work in community, and you can actually have people work in a non-hierarchical kind of system and make a system work, because, you know, capitalism tells you that doesn't work when, you know, there are instances where you see where it actually works, and it works really well, and it works to the benefit of everyone.
When I interact with people that come into the store, members, friends, non-members, people just checking it out for the first time, I get a feeling of pretty much just happiness. People love food, and when they come here, nobody really complains about the prices. They're always really excited to learn more about the products and how we run and what it takes to become a member. And I think that that's pretty neat that people can get pumped about not only food, but wanting to participate and giving back to their community.
It's one of the few places that that I know of that I can go that are founded in a cooperative spirit. And so you go to this place where a bunch of really interested, willing, and engaged people are hanging out, like, down to make stuff happen, the people who are willing to cooperate.
So Brent Roses, we got our name from a textile worker strike, a women's textile worker strike in Lawrence, Massachusetts in 1912. During that strike, the women held placards that demanded bread and roses. So by 1912, workers were getting onto the idea that wasn't just bread that they wanted. They explicitly said, we want bread and roses. Workers deserve their stake in that, in all of the good that's come from human history, and that's art, music, sciences, everything that humanity has produced up to this point. So workers deserve bread and roses. I charge up to the quick start.